Good morning, everyone. My name is Justin Meyer. I'm a Deputy Director with the Kansas City Aviation Department, and I'm so pleased to have you here with us as we celebrate a really exciting day. I'm, in fact, so excited about the arrival of JetBlue to Kansas City that I went to Boston to come in on the inaugural. It was an incredible flight. It's an amazing aircraft, and it's a really significant moment for us to have JetBlue arriving into Kansas City. Participating in today's festivities are Pat Klein, the Director of Aviation, Brian Platt, City Manager of Kansas City, Congressman and former Kansas City, Missouri Mayor Emanuel Cleaver II, and JetBlue has a representative here, the Director of Fleet Strategy, Joseph King. We're very pleased to have you all here.
In this day and age, it's not easy to land a new airline in the city. I'd like to thank JetBlue's network planners and Justin and his staff for the great work to bring JetBlue in. And I'd like to welcome JetBlue to the Kansas City International Airport.
We've got a beautiful plane that they're using here, the Airbus A220. We're really excited about new opportunities, new flights, new routes all over the place. We've got a new airport terminal opening in less than a year, and this will be a big part of that.
This is a big deal for Kansas City. We have a long, deep history with aviation that maybe even Kansas Cityans are now familiar with. When our first serious airport was opened, which is now the Charles Cleaver Airport, the keynote speaker was the famed aviation guru Charles Lindbergh, right here in Kansas City when it opened. And many of you probably don't know, and you need to know, that is that this was the world headquarters for TWA.
It's incredible to think that in just 22 years, you've grown from a small carrier to now serving more than 100 destinations across the U.S., Caribbean, Latin America, and just this past year, the United Kingdom. In fact, Kansas City becomes JetBlue's 109th destination. But adding routes like this one is so important to JetBlue's long-term success.
We've got a flight to depart, so I'm going to bring up our speakers, we're going to cut a ribbon, we're going to load a plane, and let's get this thing going.
going to show you something with a...
Safety is our top priority, so we appreciate a few minutes of your attention while we demonstrate the safety features of this aircraft. You can follow along with a safety information card in your seat back pocket. Federal aviation regulations require compliance with all crew member instructions, lighted information signs, and posted placards. To fasten your seat belt, insert the flat metal end into the buckle and pull on the strap to tighten. To release, lift the top flap of the buckle. Please keep your seatbelt fastened low and tight across your lap, even when the seatbelt sign is off, and have your seatbelt visible to the crew at all times. Your life vest is in a pouch under your seat. If instructed by the crew, retrieve the vest by pulling the tab. Tear open the pouch, remove the vest, and pull it over your head. All of our planes are equipped with free high-speed Wi-Fi. If you have a Wi-Fi-enabled device, just connect to the Fly-Fi network and type flyfi.com, that's flyfi.com, into your browser window and follow the prompts to log in. Making calls of any type while in flight is prohibited, including the use of VoIP, Voice Over Internet Protocol, video conferencing services such as Zoom. Please remain seated with seatbelts fastened and carry on the items stowed until we have safely parked at the gate and the captain has turned off the seatbelt sign. On behalf of all of us here at JetBlue, especially this Boston-based crew, thank you for flying with us today. Thank you for joining us on our first flight from KCI to New York. Flight crew, please prepare for arrival.